Hello everyone, welcome to Lesson 28. My name is Danielle. Thank you for joining me again today. Let's remember together, in Lesson 27, we explored double numbers and we practiced our doubles to six. How did you go at home? What I did is I wrote out my doubles to six in my book. This was really helpful when I played my game. One and one is two. Two and two is four. Three and three is six. Four and four is eight. Five and five is, that's right, 10. And six is 12. Did you notice that we were skip counting by twos here? Great job, everyone. Our learning intention today is to explore and use the strategy of near doubles. Now, we know that a double is when we have two of the same number. I wonder what a near double is. I have a warm-up game for us to play. What we're going to do is I will hold up a card and I need you to help me sort them. We're going to put the doubles here and the near doubles here. I would like you to do hands on heads if you think I've read out a double, and hands on shoulders if it's a near double. Are you ready? Okay, the first one, 5 and 5 is 10. What do you think? Double or near double? That's right, 5 and 5 is 10. That's a double number. The next one is 3 and 4 is 7. 3 and 4 are not the same. That must be a near double. The next one, 3 and 3 is 6. That's a double. Let's pop it here. Did you put your hands on your heads? 1 and 1 is 2. Well done. 4 and 3 is 7. It's a near double. Let's put it over here. 2 and 3 is 5. You guessed it, another near double. Oh, 6 and 5 is 11. Another near double. Oops-a-days. Oh, this one. 6 and 6 is 12. That's definitely a double. Oops. 5 and 4 is 9. That's a near double. Well done. 2 and 2 is 4. Double. Great sorting, everyone. 1 and 2 is 3. That's a near double. The last one. Hands on heads, 4 and 4 is 8. That's a double. Great job, everyone. Let's have a closer look at near doubles. I'm going to make them using some Unifix cubes. Now, we know that 1 and 1 is a double. It's 2 because they're the same. But if I add one more, it's a near double. 1 and 1 is 2 and one more is 3. Let's try another. This time, 2 and 2 is 4 and one more is 5. Another near double. Let's try another. This time, we know that 3 and 3 is, that's right, 6, and one more is 7. Now, let's make the double, then subtract 1 to find 1 less. So, we know that 4 and 4, that's a double, 4 and 4 is 8, but one less is 7. We know that this time 5 and 5 is 10. That's a double. Let's take one away. That's 9. Last one. We know that 6 and 6 is 12, but one less is 11. We are going to play the dice game just like we did in the last lesson. First, we are going to make a chart of the near doubles. Can you help me? So, 1 and 1 is 2, add 1 is 3. 2 and 2 is 4, add 1 is, that's right, 5. 3 and 3 is 6, add 1 is 7. 4 and 4 is 8, add 1 is 9. 5 and 5 is 10, add 1, it's 11. 11. And 6 and 6 is 12, add 1, and we get, that's right, 13. Now, we could have got these answers by subtracting 2, like 2 and 2 is 4, subtract 1 is 3. So, what we're going to do is get our dice, we're going to roll, double it and add 1 more. Just like last time, we want to try and cross off all our near doubles. So, 1 and 1 is 2, add 1 is 3. Let's cross off 3. Now, we get to choose each time we roll, are we going to add or are we going to subtract? Because we want them all crossed off. Shake, trap, I know that 2 and 2 is 4, add 1 is 5. Let's cross that off. Let's roll again. 6. So I could do 6 and 6 is 12, subtract 1 is 11. Let's cross off 11. And let's roll. 5 and 5 is 10. Add 1. Oh, that's 11. We've already crossed that off. I know. 5 and 5 is 10. Subtract 1 is 9. That's another one. We've only got 2 left. Okay. Shake and trap. 5 and 5 is 10. Add 1 and subtract. They're both done. I need to roll again. 4 and 4 is 8. Add 1 is 9. 4 and 4 is 8. Subtract 1 is 7. I've only got 1 left. I'm going to do 1 more roll and see how I go. A 2. I'm going to leave that there. Now, I'm noticing here that we're skip counting again. 3, 5, 7, 9. Once again, we're going up by 2s. Let's look at this on a number line. Let's start at 3. So we know that 3 and 3 more, 1, 2, 3, is 6, because that's a double. So if we know that, then 3 and 4 must be 7. Can you see how this is helping us when we're adding? Your task at home is to play the near doubles game like we've done today. Remember to write down your totals of the near doubles first and cross them off as you roll. If you would like a challenge, once again, roll 2 dice, work out how many, then find the near double. In this lesson, we have explored the near doubles strategy. Can you see how this is helpful when we are adding? Thanks for all your hard work again today. See you next time.